In this chapter, we discuss the RT web parts themselves. So first of all, let's look at some general features. The RT web parts, they're all going to update in real time, live. So I don't know if you've noticed it, but if we take a look at our, here's our RT web part that is showing a trend. This is updating in real time. Every 5 seconds, this is going out, getting a new, or excuse me, every 15 seconds, it's going out, getting all the values that have changed in the last 15 seconds, so it won't miss anything if it happens quicker than 15 seconds. It's updating in real time. Now, secondly, there is no installation needed. As I said, it's simply an SVG plugin to Internet Explorer. We can render data from lots of sources that aren't limited to PI. So you'll notice RT Baseline Services, that gets data from relational databases, web services, just a lot of different sources out there that we can read data from. Okay. It serves as a repository for files and documents, so you can link things like operating instructions, documents that help procedurally within your manufacturing or within your operations. That all can be linked right into the web parts that we serve. Especially, you can make use of things like our tree view control to go directly to the document that you need based on navigation in our tree view. And of course, it can be accessed to any viewer or anybody that's got an internet connection. So it doesn't have to go through a port like port 5450, which our regular clients have to go through. So the Adobe SVG Viewer that I mentioned, there is a bit of a hiccup in that. It has been discontinued, or it is going to be discontinued by Adobe as of January 1st of 2009. We will continue to support it. We've already got an agreement with Adobe that we will be able to distribute it at any point in the future, so there's no difficulty with it being available. And in case you're wondering, I mean, a lot of this had to do with what Adobe decided to back as their newer technology, so that's why the SVG Viewer is something that we're not seeing any new development on. And this anticipating of the same kind of SVG functionality with newer technologies, we're talking like basically about what Microsoft's coming out with their Silverlight product. Now let's do a quick rehash of something we've done already once before already, but let's just take a look at it again. Let's look at how we would actually add a web part to an existing web part page. Now I'm going to go back in my let me go back to my sample site, and let's take a look at how we would add to one of these web part pages. So I'm going to go ahead and get into the edit mode by choosing Site Actions, Edit Page. And if you're on a web part page, when you do that, you should see the zones appear. With the zones, you have the option to drop a web part into any one of these zones. And I'll just do that by clicking on Add a Web Part. And this dialog box appears. This shows me the list of web parts that are available. And if we scroll down, we'll see the web part that we're interested in for this class. This is the RT web parts, starting right here. Now once you've chosen a web part, like for example if I choose this gauge right here, after you've added it, then you're going to have to configure that web part, and we'll get to that in the future video. Now there's the web part, unconfigured at this point.